Listening to Myself by Al Purdy. Alfred Wellington Purdy, Canadian poet born on December 30, 1918. Called as nation's unofficial poet. Attended Albert College and Trenton Collegiate Institute in Ontario. Served in the Royal Canadian Air Force during World War II. In 1957, Purdy and his wife Eurytha moved to Robin Lake in Ontario and built an A-frame cottage which he preferred as his writing location. Works include 39 books of poetry, a novel, 2 volumes of memoirs and 4 books of correspondence. Received awards such as Order of Canada in 1982, Order of Ontario in 1987 and the Governor General's Award in 1965. Died on April 21, 2000. Listening to Myself. Published posthumously in 2000 in the collection Beyond Remembering, the collected poems of Al Purdy. Poem carries a high diction. Expresses personal experience in a sad tone. Recollects the past and depicts the love towards the nation and longing to survive. Summary. Poem starts by introducing the narrator as an old man who is staggering through the deep snow. He is weak and seems to be looking at himself from different angles from above, front and both sides. The poet describes the appearance of the old man with wrinkled face and hands and white hair who is lugging blocks of wood. Indirectly, the poet is stating that he is carrying the memories of the past. He tells that his voice must express love even when he is listening to the ridiculous things happening in the land. As the nation has changed a lot, he considers himself as a foolish man with huge love towards the hostile nation. It is spirit of nationality which is making him to survive even though he is very old and stumbling through the snow. The new generation influenced by the colonizers lost the love towards the nation and also degraded the traditional culture of the nation. The poet sees the still pool in the forest which reflects only the past and nothing more. He states that his mind is like the still pool which reflects only the past memories. Though the poet is kind, he gets angry remembering the violence and cultural changes happened in the nation. He realizes that it is not the physical strength that helped him to survive but the love towards his nation helped him to survive. The poet consoles himself that the past cannot be brought back and therefore wants to celebrate the loss of a way of life through poetry. For more videos, like, share, subscribe. Thank you.